अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू विल बी फाइन। एज यू मे नो दैट आई मेक एन एजुकेशनल चैनल फॉर यू टू अपलोड एंड रिकॉर्ड द लेक्चर्स एंड द वीडियो फॉर यू। सेकेंड सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट्स ऑलरेडी हैव टू आर थ्री लेक्चर एंड दिस इज योर फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर that is uploaded on my channel and you will subscribe that channel by clicking the bell button and then you can listen and see the video of this lecture. And before going to this lecture, I want to tell you that we have few lecture before the corona period, and then in this corona period when the classes was not going on, I give you the number of assignments and you completed that assignments on the portal, and now we are taking the classes on this channel. So to study and to learn this lecture, you must have to read the basics of our course lipids and the properties, role and the function of the simple lipids, because this lecture is a little bit heavy and advanced than the previous lectures which you have taken in the classroom already. So come to the topic of this lecture. Today we are I'm going to discuss what are the phospholipids, glycerophospholipids, sphingomyelins and glycolipids. And this is as it is present in your contents of your course. So first we can we know the role and the function of the simple lipids, and we should know the phospholipids, what are the phospholipids and where they are present and what are their usual functions. So normally the phospholipids are the major contents of all the cell membranes, the cell which have the cell membrane, in which the major constituents, which we said the bilayer lipids, bilayer cell membrane, that are made up of the phospholipids. This is also the components of bile, and also used to anchor the protein in the membrane. Phospholipids are the signal mediators as well, and they are the components of the lipoprotein. Phospholipids, glycerophospholipids and sphingomyelins, are all of these are the compound lipids, and these are the macromolecule. As they are compound in their structure, so to well understand the every complex lipids, we should have to know the structure of these phospholipids, glycerolipids and the sphingomyelin. So first of all, the structure of the phospholipid, as we know that the complex lipids are made from the triglycerides or the diglycerides, and if the glycerol is attached with the two fatty acid, it's called diacyl glycerol, and if the glycerol is attached with the three fatty acid, then it's called the triacyl glycerol. Phospholipids have the two fatty acid that form first of all diacyl glycerol, and the third carbon of the glycerol backbone is occupied by a modified phosphate group. And because of this modified phosphate group, it becomes the phosphatidate or phosphatidic acid. And in chemical or chemistry name, we can say that it's a diacyl glycerol 3-phosphate. It is still a precursor of any phospholipids or a phospholipids. To become a phospholipids, phosphatidic acid, phosphate group should be modified by an alcohol. Phosphatidylcholine and phosphatidylserine are the examples of two important phospholipids that are found in the plasma membrane. And the key of this structure is that phosphatidic acid that is actually the 3-diacylglycerol 3-phosphate. It's one of the alcohol is modified by choline or serine, then it become the phospholipids. You can see the structure of the phosphatidic acid, and then it become the phospholipids. And in this structure, a glycerol is the backbone. The first glycerol is attached with a fatty acid, long chain fatty acid. The second glycerol carbon atom is also attached with the long chain fatty acid. The third carbon of glycerol is attached with the phosphate group, and it becomes the phosphatidic acid. If this phosphate group is modified by a serine amino acid, actually the phospholipids are the amphipathic molecule. Amphipathic molecules are those molecules which have the hydrophobic as well as the hydrophilic end. Its hydrophilic end, the head group attached the alcohol via phosphodiester linkage to either of the diacyl glycerol glycerophospholipids or the sphingophospholipids, I mean the sphingomyelines. So if we see the phospholipids and the parallel to that one, the glycolipids, the phospholipids may be further classified as the glycerophospholipids and the sphingolipids. And the glycolipids are also called the sphingolipids. Glycerophospholipids have the two fatty acid groups and a phosphodiester linkage of third carbon of glycerol with the alcohol. Then it becomes the glycerophospholipids. In the sphingolipids, the sphingosine is attached with the one fatty acid and a phosphodiester linkage is attached with the choline or ethanol amine. And if these sphingolipids are attached with the galactose, glucose, galactose amine, oligosaccharides, then it becomes the glycolipids. As we told, the major constituents of the cell membranes are the phospholipids and the sphingolipids. Before, glycerolipids and phospholipids spontaneously self-associate in the water to form the bilayer vesicles, as in the diagram shows, and that close the membrane. These bilayer are the permeability barrier that encloses the cells and the cells organelles, and also dissolve the intrinsic membrane proteins, which are visible in the diagram. Second major class of phospholipids is the glycerophospholipids. Glycerophospholipids are the main class of phospholipids, and they are the main lipids component of the cell membrane and are the important in the cell semipermeability. They also interact with the triacylglycerols and cholesterol to increase their solubility in the blood. These ability of glycerophospholipids are due to their amphipathic nature, and we have already discussed the amphipathic nature that have the polar head group and the nonpolar tail group. If you see the diagram, you will find that the glycerol is attached with the two fatty acids, and the third carbon of the glycerol is attached with the phosphate group and then an amino alcohol with the help of the phosphodiester bond. The fatty acids and the amino alcohol part, of the glycerophospholipids are the head, and they are polar in nature, and the fatty acids, long chain hydrocarbons, are the nonpolar in nature. Glycerophospholipids are similar to the triacylglycerols, but have the one ester bond replaced with an amino alcohol phosphate ester, and it is appeared and clear in the diagram as well. Each of the phosphoglycerolipids includes a polar region and a nonpolar region. Carbonyl oxygen of fatty acid. Each glycerophospholipid includes a polar region and a nonpolar region. Carbonyl oxygen of fatty acid, inorganic phosphate, and the polar head group. Any of the polar head group together makes a polar region. Hydrocarbon tails of the fatty acid, that is R1 and R2, are the nonpolar region, and it's clear in the diagram as well. So if we simply see the structure of a glycerophospholipid, we can see in the diagram a long chain fatty acid and then another long chain fatty acid attached with the glycerol backbone, and that glycerol backbone is attached with the phosphate group, and that phosphate group is attached with an amino alcohol through the phosphodiester bond, and that amino alcohol green part is called the polar head, and the blue and the yellow region is called the nonpolar tail of the glycerophospholipids. Glycerophospholipids can be further classified on the basis of the amino alcohol group into two major classes. The two major types are the lecithines and the cephalines. Lecithines are those in which the amino alcohol group is choline, and the cephaline glycerophospholipids are those which contain the ethanol amine as the amino alcohol group. Lecithin and cephalines are highly abundant in the brain and nerve cells tissues, and are also found in the egg yolk, wheat, germs, and yeast. The simple structure of a lecithin and a cephalines are present in the video. Phosphatidyl inositol also present as a polar group and is also a one major type of glycerophospholipids. And it's in its function, it's a brain membrane lipids, as well as it has the role in the cell signaling. There is another one major example of cardiolipids, and a cardiolipin is found in the mitochondrial membrane. It is a glycerophospholipid as well. The structure of the cardiolipin shows that it has the two glycerol backbone attached with the two fatty acids, and both of these unit attach with the help of a phosphodiester bond of their phosphate group on the third carbon atom of each unit. So it become diphosphatidyl glycerol or the cardiolipin. Sphingomyelins are the phospholipids, that is the third major type of the phospholipids. These are based on the 18 carbon amino alcohol sphingosine instead of on the glycerol as the backbone. In the structure of sphingomyelin, a fatty acid linked to the amino group by an amide bond, and an amino alcohol phosphate ester is linked to the bottom hydroxyl group. The top hydroxyl group remains free. As in the diagram, the sphingomyelin is the main component of myelin sheath of nerve cell. What is the myelin sheath? The myelin sheath is an insulating covering of the nerve cells, brain cells, that help to pass the signals or the impulses to the different part of the body. The amino group of sphingosine can form an amide bond with the fatty acid carboxylic group to yield a ceramide. In the more complex sphingolipids, a polar head group is esterified to the terminal hydroxyl group of sphingosine moiety of the ceramide and can make a complex sphingolipids. Sphingomyelin has a phosphocholine or the phosphoethanol amine as a head group. Sphingomyelin are the common constituent of the plasma membrane with the phosphocholine head group is similar in size and shape to the glycerophospholipids, phosphatidylcholine. Glycolipids. Glycolipids are the third major type of phospholipids. In our lecture today, glycolipids are actually sphingolipids that have one or more monosaccharide linked by the glycosidic bonds linkage to the bottom hydroxyl group of sphingosine. In contrast to the sphingomyelins, they do not have a phosphocholine group. There are two major types of glycolipids are the glycosphingolipids. One is cerebrosides. Cerebrosides have a single monosaccharides, usually the galactose, attached on the terminal third hydroxyl group of the sphingosine, and they are usually, cerebrosides are usually present at the cell surface and are involved in the cellular recognition and immunity. From the structure, it is clearly visible that what are the cerebrosides. The second major type is the gangliosides. They have the two or more monosaccharides, usually glucose and galactose, and they are also clear from their structure. They are abundant in the cell membrane of the neurons, and they act at the cell surface at the receptors for hormones. In the functions of the glycolipids, they are part of the cell membrane as many other phospholipids, glycerophospholipids, sphingomyelins are the part of the cell membranes. Glycolipids also help to determine the blood group of an individual, and the glycolipids act as a receptor at the surface of the red blood cells. Some viruses, bacteria, for example cholera, use the glycolipids on their cell surface as well, and they help the immune system destroy and clear the pathogens from the body. So today we studied phospholipids, glycerophospholipids, sphingomyelins and glycolipids. Their structure, their presence, their function and their critical role in the body. I hope you will see and watch this video two or three times to completely understand the contents of the lecture so you can deliver them in the exam as well. Thank you.